Question number 44. An NPN transistor is connected in a voltage divider configuration as shown in the figure below. So voltage divider here, the resistor R1 as well as R2, whatever the voltage is given here, that will be divided between these two resistors. That's why this configuration is called the voltage divider circuit. If the resistor R2 is disconnected, the voltage VB at the base and VC at the collector changes as the follows. That means the voltage here, they are asking, this is a voltage V actually here in this collector. This is a VC voltage, then this is a VB voltage. So what would happen? These two voltage, if you are removing that, this collector resistance, if you are removing suddenly, what would happen to these two resistance? This is the thing we are going to see conceptually, as well as the we are going to derive the sum of the result.
First we can draw the given circuit. So there is a resistor here, it is an 80 kilo ohm resistor R1. Then here also there is a one resistor, that R2 is 20 kilo ohm. Then in between the base, here they connected the NPN transistor. It is usually represented by the outward arrow. This is an emitter. In the emitter region, they have connected RE 1 kilo ohm. In the similar manner, there is a collector. Collector, they have connected RC is equal to 5 kilo ohm. Then this is an 20 volt. This you can call it's VCC. So 20 volt it is connected across, it is grounded, all the parts are it's grounded. This is a given circuit. This is a one NPN transistor. Then what their question is, they are asking, suppose if the resistor R2 is removed, what would happen to the circuit if the resistor R2 is disconnected? If it is disconnected, so what would happen to the VB and VC, they are asking. So this is the question we are going to answer today. Suppose first thing we want to know, the in the voltage divider circuit, we are going to remove the R2. So the voltage drop across the R2, that will be equal to, you can call this is a base voltage, because this is a base. Here this is an emitter terminal, this is a collector terminal. So the voltage drop across this resistor, in general it is equal to, it's a VB, the voltage drop, because it's a ground, it's a base. So the voltage across our two resistor is VB, that should be equal to, in general it is equal to VCC, the voltage time the resistor R2 divided by the series resistor R1 plus R2. So this is a voltage drop across resistor. Now if it is removed, that means R2 goes to zero, then we can think VB goes to zero, but that is not actually true case. This VCC, the voltage given to the circuit, it is divided between the resistor R1 as well as R2. This is a net voltage across the R1 plus R2 is equal to the VCC. So what would happen, once if it is removed, then the net voltage drop is happening across the R1. So actually VB can hold the extra voltage across it. So VB will get increase. So the next question we are going to answer, what would happen to the VC? This is the question we are going to answer. For this one, we are going to use the Kirchhoff voltage law. Here if you are taking, it's a 20 voltage is here, that is equal to VCC, it's a constant voltage. The voltage drop between these two, it's equal to VC. Here ICRC, the extra voltage drop between this resistor, it's equal to ICRC. So across this resistor, the voltage drop, it's equal to IC RC, because the current is IC is going here, so IC is going upward direction. So according to the voltage draw, the VCC that should be equal to this voltage drop. This is actually source voltage that should be equal to IC for this circuit. This closed circuit, it's equal to IC RC plus it's a VC. They are asking VC, what is going to happen to VC? VC is equal to it's a VCC minus IC RC. But we don't know whether it will get increase or decrease the VC. So for that, we are going to use another Kirchhoff voltage law for this circuit. Here the voltage drop between these two terminal, it's a VBE. This is VB. Between this terminal, this is actually VE. So using this circuit law, you can calculate this VB. VB, actually the current is going this direction, that is IB, this is current direction. So in general, the current will flow here, then it's going this way. So what would happen? This VB, actually this is current in opposite direction. So you can call it some minus VBE. It's also minus VE. This goes to zero. This is a Kirchhoff voltage law for this loop. So we can ask one question. What's the actual thing happening here? So you can just do that. What is your VE? That should be equal to VB minus VBE. This is the voltage across this resistor, that RE. So suppose we can say the VE, that should be equal to IE divided by RE. If IE increases, then VE will increase. That is one thing we can conclude. So we can say the IE is approximately equal to IC for the common emitter circuit. So once if the IE is lifted, then this will also will be lifted. Why the VE is increases means already we know, we told the VB is increasing, hence this is a positive quantity compared to VBE. If the positive quantity, positive voltage is increases, then definitely the VE will increase. If the VE will get increased, then definitely the IE will increase. If the IE will increase, then definitely IC also increase. Once if the IC is getting increased, this quantity, the IC is getting increased, then this is a negative quantity. This quantity keep on will increase. That means the net result will be reducing. That means the VC will be reduced from the original value. Hence, the VB will get increased because we are removing the resistor R2. VC will be reduced, so VB will get increased, VC will be get reduced. Because of this increment, IE will get increased, VB will get increased, VE will increase, IE will increase. If IE is increases, IC also get increased. If IC increases, then this quantity resultant will be get decreased, then VC will be reduced. So these are the two conclusions we can give for the given circuit.
So from our above discussion, we can conclude the two options are ruled out because both cannot increase, both cannot decrease. So VB decreases and VC increases. This is not the answer. So here the VB increases, but VC decreases. This is the right option.